Everybody's got the spelling on the name?
Yeah, good afternoon, Hiro Toya. I'm the Director of Emergency Management, City and County of Honolulu. As you all have seen, there's some potentially severe weather coming our way this weekend. And we wanted to get the message out to the public to make sure that everybody's aware of what we might expect this weekend. So for Oahu, Saturday night into Sunday morning, Sunday afternoon, we have a potential to see some significant coastal inundation along the north shore. And coupled with that is a potentially significant wind event. So I want to talk about those two hazards. Let me first start with the wind impacts. Right now there's a wind advisory in place for most of the state, but we might be seeing a high wind warning going into place this weekend. And so what that means is because of the direction the wind's coming from, we could see some additional impacts from that wind, additional tree branches going down, utility poles, and potentially debris in the air that could impact our transportation networks. So we want to let people know that there's potential for these impacts this weekend. So be flexible with your travel plans this weekend, as the highways could be impacted, roadways could be impacted, and also be prepared around your home. You know, if you have any loose objects that you can secure, we would highly recommend that you do so at this point. But the city is maintaining situational awareness, and we're maintaining a posture of readiness to respond if we need to, should there be significant debris on the roadways that we need to handle. So that's the wind impacts. And we're also potentially going to see some high surf impacts, including coastal inundation. And we're particularly looking at the north shore of Oahu as an area of concern. Now, for those residents that are on the north shore, we want them to be really vigilant this weekend. It is possible that we have some homes that get impacted by this wave event. We've been in close contact with the National Weather Service and the rest of the state since yesterday. And this particular weather pattern that we're seeing now, National Weather Service is telling us that they haven't seen a pattern like this in some time. And so we don't exactly know what the impacts are going to be, but the potential is significant. And so for those folks that are living on the North Shore, we would urge them to be vigilant and be prepared for the possibility that they may need to evacuate their homes. And we will be issuing messages to the public throughout the day as needed. We have our HNL.info app. National Weather Service would also be issuing messages, and we'll also be reaching out through traditional media to get the word out about potential impacts. If we need to, we will open shelters to support the evacuees. Okay, so that's all I have for now. I'm open it up for questions.
Any message for folks likely to go to the North Shore just to see the big monster waves?
I'll let Jim speak a little bit to that, but the type of waves that we're going to see this weekend is not going to be the type of waves that people are going to be out surfing in. The winds are going to be strong, and the conditions are really not going to be favorable. In addition to that, there is a possibility that waves are going to be overtopping onto the roads. And so that means that traffic could be impacted, and it might not be the best day to try to get around the island. So asking everybody to be flexible with their plans and then their outdoor activities. And ultimately, our concern is public safety. And we don't want anybody getting put in harm's way, and we also don't want to put our emergency responders in harm's way either.
Any specific crews that are going to be out in the North Shore just as, you know, precautionary reasons? Do you have any crews that are going to be dispatched out that way?
We'll be activating our Emergency Management Reserve Corps. So you'll see the DEM volunteers out there. We want to make sure that everybody out there is aware of what's coming. And so we'll be doing some enhanced outreach in that community.
And you're talking specifically just that North Shore stretch that's along Kamehameha Highway, Wailua, Haleiwa as well?
Yeah, so we're looking at Mokulea all the way up to Sunset Beach and beyond. That's our current target area, but we're going to be continuing to stay in contact with the National Weather Service and the Hawaii Emergency Management Agency. We'll be discussing with them tomorrow afternoon to sort of finalize our plans going into the evening. And so that is our current plan, but depending on the forecast, how things might change, we're also looking at the leeward side as well. So if there's a need for doing enhanced outreach on the west side, we'll be doing that as well.
For those who choose to shelter in place, what would your recommendation be?
Please be vigilant, pay attention to your surroundings and to the wave conditions, and make plans to be able to quickly evacuate your home if you need to. We hope you don't have to, but be prepared to do that if the need comes.
Will the city be looking at pre-securing some of the roads that have gotten, tree branches have fallen over, like Holly or Lee David Bay? Will there be some work done to secure those areas?
We'll be working with the Department of Transportation, State Department of Transportation Highways. And of course, Honolulu Police Department is always going to be out there to support any road closures that's necessary to ensure public safety.
And what are the locations?
Kimberly, just to be clear, those facilities that you mentioned are all state controlled.
And what locations are you guys looking at for potentially opening shelters in the north?
That's still to be determined. We're continuing to have meetings this afternoon and tomorrow to finalize those plans, and we'll be sure to let the public know exactly where those locations will be.
When would you expect the peak of any severe either waves or wind would happen? You mentioned from Saturday to Sunday.
Yeah.
Is there a real window where...
We're looking at Sunday morning to afternoon as potentially the peak, but there's definitely some level of unknown with the system, so we're continuing to monitor the system really closely.
Harold, you want to explain how folks on the North Shore almost should prepare almost as a flood event if they're along the coastline and maybe move up their valuables from the first floor and get that stuff out of the room?
Yeah, that's a possibility. So folks living on the North Shore should be prepared for the potential for inundation of their homes from the wave action this weekend. So if there's at all any way to protect your valuables on the ground level, we would encourage folks to do so. And again, also be prepared to evacuate their homes. If there's any signs that waves are coming into your homes, then we would urge those folks to evacuate their homes and go to a safe location. Okay.
Okay, we'll bring in Director Howe.
All right, thank you.
Okay.
Hello.
Do you have an opening statement, Director?
No, I don't. So I just thought I would really, Hero covered most of the big impacts around the island here, or at least on the North Shore. So I wanted to be available for questions, specifically with the beaches and the shoreline areas. But I do want to emphasize one thing, that although this storm system is moving through and it's primarily going to impact the North Shore, it looks like, we live on an island. And that means that these wave impacts will potentially hit all of our shorelines. And at what we're seeing at the moment is that we're seeing impacts especially down the windward coast. If it gets as big as projected, we will see wraparound effects at places like Sandy Beach, even Diamond Head, coming down around the east side. So one of the things we'd like to emphasize is that no matter where you are on the beaches or on the shorelines, there is a potential for a wave run-up, unusually high wave run-up. So please, if it's wet, don't go out on those ledges. Places like Makapu Tide Pools, which is pretty remote. We've had people swept off into the ocean down there. This is a potentially hazardous situation. So this is for visitors in particular who may not be familiar with the kinds of conditions that we see here on the islands when we get a big surf episode. I would like to reemphasize what Hero said. For those folks that are visiting the island, this isn't the kind of surf you're going to go and get a picture of one of our famous big wave surfers. Nobody's in the water on the North Shore right now. It's too rough. It's onshore. It's victory at sea. There really isn't going to be any ability to even get out on the beach. Our lifeguards will be basically warning people from even walking down on the sand. So it's not a great time to head out to the North Shore and think you're going to get that picture or see that kind of famous Hawaiian surf that everybody wants to see. So that's my 2 points.
Will lifeguard force and hours be extended?
If needed. So like our ocean safety program, we are very adaptive. We're always looking at the conditions, and all of our lifeguards around the island have been given the authorization to do overtime, bring in additional assets, but we're gonna gauge the conditions. And it's not just the conditions, but how many people are actually in these areas. We want to make sure we move our resources and our assets to where they're going to do the most good.
You know, with some of the other storms that we've had in 2018, for example, there's been all this preparation ahead of time, you know, stock up on water and food, et cetera. Are you recommending people, not just on the North Shore, but folks down here on the Windward Coast, are you recommending they do the same?
I don't believe that's really necessary, but I'll defer to Hero. This is not a hurricane. This is high wind episode, and so we have impacts, you know, things like branches flying or things like that, but I don't think we're looking at a large scale entire island circumstance here. It's much more localized out to the North Shore, and those communities or those homes and areas right on the shoreline.
Neighbor islands are also prepared for big waves. Or any message to them?
Same as us. We all get the same surf that comes through. It always typically hits Kauai first. Oftentimes Kauai's a little bit bigger. And as it moves down the island chain, it kind of diminishes a little bit. Big Island is very different than Kauai and Oahu because they don't have the fringing reefs. Maui will see some impacts, but they're pretty sheltered by Molokai. Molokai's gonna have some impacts over there. There's gonna be some pretty big surf over on Molokai.
Thanks, Director Howe. Okay. And Director Toy also wanted to add that we should always have our 14-day kits ready no matter what, even on a blue sky day like today. And then he wants to make a further point, if anybody should find themselves in the predicament of being trapped under power lines that should fall on their vehicle, he's going to kind of give a briefing on what folks should do in that case.
Yeah. We don't believe this weekend's event's going to be like a hurricane event, but we do urge everybody to be prepared year-round because we never know what can affect us. So we encourage everybody to always be prepared, have their 14-day supply kit. You know, before a hurricane is approaching when a hurricane is approaching isn't really the time that we want folks to be prepared. So we recommend that everybody stay prepared year-round, have a plan of what you're going to do, where you might go, have your supplies, and know how to stay informed. So that means staying tuned to local news, to official social media, and to the official messages that we're going to be issuing. And you know, this is going to be a wind event, so there is a possibility for power outages. So folks who are dependent on power for their medical devices or for other reasons, they also definitely need to be ready year-round. Now, to Andrew's point about what to do if a power line were to come down directly onto your vehicle, we urge folks to stay calm and pull over safely and call 911. Help is going to come, and let the professionals handle it. Never try to handle a power line because you don't know if it's energized or not and how that might impact you.
Further questions? Great. Thanks, guys. Appreciate it.